Hi, my name is Patrick Boyle. Welcome to my YouTube channel where we learn all about derivatives and quantitative finance. In today's video, we're going to learn about value at risk, or VaR as it's often known. If this is the first video you're watching, make sure you click the subscribe button to see more content like this. By the end of the video, you'll know what VaR is and how it works. Risk management is a specialized field, and whole books have been written on topics that I will cover in a few sentences here. As you can imagine, it is a detailed and well-studied field, but my goal with this video is to give you a quick understanding of some of the important ideas in risk management, in particular, value at risk, or VaR. While there are many sources of financial risk, we're going to be concentrating here on market risk, meaning the risk of unexpected changes in market prices. My prior videos on the Greeks gives a lot of useful information to traders who are managing a portfolio of options within a financial institution. Financial institutions will calculate all of the Greeks on a daily or more frequent basis. This risk information provides traders and desk heads useful information, but when combined with risk information for all of the different departments of a large financial institution, such calculations can become of limited use to senior management. Value at risk, or VaR, is an attempt to measure risk and put it in the format of a single number so that financial risk can be quickly explained and understood. It's worth noting that this is both the best and the worst thing about VaR. VaR is defined as the predicted loss at a specific confidence interval, usually 95% or 99%, over a certain period of time. The VaR risk measure defines risk as mark-to-market loss on a fixed portfolio over a fixed time horizon. For example, if a portfolio of stocks has a one-day 95% VaR of $1 million, that tells you that based upon the risk model, there's a 5% chance that the portfolio will fall in value by $1 million or more over a one-day period, assuming markets are normal and that no changes are made to the portfolio. Now, it's very important to highlight that or more. The VaR number doesn't tell you that the loss will be limited to $1 million. It tells you that you will have a loss of that or greater over that period at that type of frequency. Another way of thinking about this is that a loss of $1 million or more is expected in this portfolio one day in every 20-day period. As you can see on screen right now, we're looking at a distribution of portfolio returns, and the VaR break is any return within the highlighted tail. Under normal market conditions, you would expect this to happen on 5% of the days. To be clear, when I mentioned a moment ago that this should occur one every 20 days, I cringe a little bit inside, as while one out of 20 days is 5% of the time, it would be unusual for your 5% of worst days to happen in an evenly spaced manner. Often in the real world, bad days tend to cluster. We will talk more about that later. The history of VaR. VaR emerged in the late 1980s and early 1990s, triggered by the 1987 crash. Many quantitative trading desks at large financial institutions claim to have been using the concept of VaR before 1990, but at that point it was not referred to as VaR, and no large institutions had implemented it firm-wide. JP Morgan was the first bank to use VaR business-wide to make sure different desks were not all exposed to the same risks. It was known as the 415 report, as the CEO, Dennis Weatherstone, demanded that a report combining all of the firm's risk on one page be available to him within 15 minutes of the market's 4 p.m. close. JP Morgan published the methodology in 1994, and in 1996 spun off the methodology into Risk Metrics Group, where it could be implemented at other firms. In 1997, the SEC required public corporations to disclose quantitative information about their derivatives activity, and VaR started turning up in financial statements in 1999. The Basel II Accord listed VaR as the preferred measure of market risk. It's worth mentioning at this point that in our prior videos on options and option pricing, volatility was usually spoken about in terms of volatility per year. In VaR calculations, we're usually talking about daily losses, and for that reason, we talk about volatility per day. When the distribution is stable, one can translate VaR over different time periods using the formula that you can see on screen right now. 10-day VaR, for example, is equal to 1-day VaR times the square root of 10. So which VaR should we use? VaR can be calculated at any confidence level. It is most common to talk about 95 VaR and 99 VaR. 95 VaR can also be expressed as VaR 5% and 99 VaR as VaR 1%. It's really just a different way of saying the same thing. It's usually referred to, though, as a 1-day calculation or a 1-day loss measure. In essence, these calculations aim to answer the question, what does a typical bad day look like? Tune in next week to my next video, which will show you two different methods we can use to calculate VaR. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button so that you can be notified when each new video is released. I upload one new video each week. Hit the like button if you found this video helpful. See you later. Bye.